Hey, what is up, Nation? In this session, we're going to be going over 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 ways that you can be using SketchUp to make money. The first way is to get a job in architecture. That's a traditional job, so you would go to school or learn how to draft, and then find your way into an architecture firm or an interior design firm where you can use your skills and SketchUp. So basically in this particular scenario, SketchUp is secondary, that it might help you find a job or get a job in that field if that's what you want to do. But nonetheless, it's a perfectly viable way to get a job using architecture. Number two is to essentially become a consultant for architecture and interior design firms making SketchUp models. So a lot of smaller architecture and interior design firms don't want to spend the time to do their own 3D models. It can take time, and they want somebody who's really quick at doing that if they ever need to develop a 3D rendering or something like that. They might do everything by hand. So finding those firms is a really great way to get essentially a niche market. And you get to use SketchUp and really hone your skills, and you can make money that way. Three. Now we're going to start to get into ways to make money in SketchUp that are a little less traditional. So three is marketing your services on freelance websites like Upwork and Fiverr. So you would go on there, you'd create a freelancer account, and then you'd start to sell your services. There are a lot of people who have drawings, or they do their own drawings and they want it refined, or they want to see it in 3D. So that's a really great way to find clients all over the world who are looking for architectural or design services. Number four is to design objects that you can then sell on 3D model websites. So there are a bunch of gaming websites. I'll list them in the comments below. I've never done this before, but I know it's pretty lucrative and a lot of people do it. Like for games, you can put 3D assets on there, and if people like them, then they pay you for them. Obviously, it's tough to gain a lot of traction through that, but if you're looking for a little bit of passive income and you just like modeling SketchUp, it might be a great option for you. Number five is to do 3D renderings of your models. If you have a realistic photo rendering plugin, or even if you don't, there's a wide range of people who are looking for different images for different reasons. Obviously, it's a slow revenue grower. You're not going to make $1 million overnight, probably. But you know, if you've already modeled something and you just want to hit render and then sell that image, really not a big problem. Number six is really similar to five, where we were talking about selling your images on stock photo websites. Six can be great if you use animations. You can charge a whole lot more for animations. It's kind of like a bunch of pictures. And it's pretty niche at this point. So there's a lot of people looking for different kinds of animations, and SketchUp has that built into it. So you can do really simple animations, or if you have a rendering software that can render a higher quality image, you can do that as well. And like I said before, this is another passive income stream. You're probably not going to be a millionaire overnight, but you know, to make a few hundred bucks probably isn't a month, isn't that unreasonable. Number seven is essentially what I do. I teach people about SketchUp, and I love that aspect of what I do. I love teaching, and I don't make a ton of money from what I do on here. The amount that I make through YouTube is pretty minimal, but I love it. I love teaching you guys things and sharing what I know, because a lot of what I know I kind of take for granted. I think that, oh yeah, everybody knows this, but it turns out no, that's not true. And I think that's part of a thing, if you decide to start teaching SketchUp, that you need to get over is just realize that there are people that don't know as much as you, and if you're just a step ahead of somebody, you can really help them. So you can teach people through YouTube videos like I do. You can teach them through courses, online courses, or physical courses at a school or something like that. You can teach them through, I said courses online, like places like Udemy will let you host a course. You can make videos like I do and host a course on Udemy. You can also do like a tutoring in person for someone. So those are great ways, if you like teaching, that you might want to get into that. And that's the last way that I think that you can make money using SketchUp. So hopefully this helped. If you like this video, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video with your friends. And as always, happy hacking.
All right, designers, just because this episode of Designer Hacks is over doesn't mean we're leaving you out in the cold. Tony's got tons of great content available at designerhacks.com. So join Design Nation right now, and we'll see you on the next episode of Designer Hacks.